I'm Kim Coleman, a co-founder here at Paid Memberships Pro. In this section, I'm going to set up a new paid membership level for my demo site that we're working on here. We already completed the initial setup, including installing and downloading Paid Memberships Pro. We activated the plugin and walked through the setup wizard. Now I'm going to navigate into the dashboard of Paid Memberships Pro and set up a paid membership level. To do this, there's two ways to get to this area. I'm on the front end of my site, logged in as an administrator. I'm going to go to Memberships Settings, and I'll see I'm on this screen called Membership Levels. This is where I set up all of my membership level groups and individual membership levels. Now, level groups are something that came in Paid Memberships Pro 3.0, and it allows you to define how do membership levels interact with one another within that group. So you can set up a group where the membership levels require someone to only hold one at a time. If I check out for one level in the group and decide to upgrade later, it will remove that lower tier level and replace it with the new checkout. You can also set up level groups where they're more a la carte and individual, and you can hold multiple levels within that group. So I could set up another group of levels that allow people to have multiple selections. So why don't I do that now just so you can see that process? If I go to Add New Group, I can name the group. And I can check this box to allow multiple selections. That means that any levels I place in this group, the person can have as many as they want. If I had 10 levels in my a la carte group, a member could decide to purchase each of them. And they can have separate recurring subscriptions or be one-time payments or free levels, however you choose to set this up. But in my main group here, this was in the initial setup wizard video. If you watched that one, we set up this basic free level. I'm going to click Add New Level in this group to add a premium tier. I'm going to make it a monthly membership level, and I will call it Premium. So let's go through all of these settings just so it's really clear what everything is here on this screen. I named my membership level. That is a name that members will see. It will show up on their membership levels page, in their checkout and confirmation, in emails, and on their membership account page. The level group, we already chose our main group. We don't want to put this in our a la carte. This is going to be like an upgraded tier from our basic level. We can add a description that will show up on the checkout page. You can add an image in this if you wanted to. You could format the text differently. I'm just going to add a really basic statement here. And then in the confirmation message, this will show up on the membership confirmation page. And you can also update your checkout emails to include this message. You can add things that link to different things on your site if you wanted to jump people right to different links from that confirmation page or however you wanted to do it. So that's your confirmation message. You can leave it blank. It's not required in this field at all. So we chose a monthly membership level template that already pre-populated as a $25 a month membership. So let's talk about what all these pricing fields are. The initial payment is charged at checkout. So that's the amount that's charged immediately when the member completes your membership checkout page and enters their payment information. For a monthly subscription, most people have the initial payment and the billing amount equal to the same amount. The recurring subscription is always charged one term after the initial checkout. So if you had a $0 initial payment on a $25 per month membership, that would mean that at checkout, the member is charged nothing. And 1 month after that checkout point, it would begin their recurring $25 per month subscription. So you could set it up like this if you wanted to offer a free trial for the first month. But I'm just going to make this $25, where it's $25 per month and they're charged immediately at checkout. My billing amount, $25 per month. Paid Memberships Pro also supports daily, weekly, monthly, and annual memberships. And you can enter different amounts. If you wanted to have a quarterly payment, you could enter per 3 months, which would divide that year into four equal payments. So you can get creative with that. Billing cycle limit isn't going to be used in this demo, but I can explain what that would be. This is if you had an installment type payment where the member was charged 3 recurring payments of $100, and then membership could continue. It's a great way to break down a large cost membership, maybe a one-time or a lifetime type membership with no expiration, where you didn't want to charge someone $1,000 at once, and you said, let's break this up into 3 $330 payments for the first 3 months. So that's an option to do a billing cycle limit. You can also add a custom trial, or here's expiration details. So for our example here, our initial payment, $25 per 1 month, we want that to keep charging ongoing. We don't want it to ever end. We don't want it to ever expire or stop recharging unless that member chooses to cancel. So for this, that would be how we would exactly set up a membership with recurring. If you had a membership level that was a one-time payment for a fixed period of membership, let's say 1 year, you could optionally set up a membership access to expire. You'll see this notice here. This is just to catch people who think that they need both expiration and billing, which we don't need for this site. So explore those expiration settings if it makes sense for you. But for most sites, you won't want an expiration. You'll just want people to continue to be rebilled according to that schedule of your billing periods. This next section has to do with how is content protected for this membership level. So you can protect posts at the category level. You can also protect single posts, single pages, and all kinds of other content. There's a link in the description for how to protect 28 different types of WordPress content. I'm not going to go through all the ways we can restrict content in this tutorial, but there's tons of different content types you can protect, from courses and media, forums, downloads, products shopped in your store, all kinds of stuff. So just here on the site, if we had a premium member category, we could protect it here for this content. This final box, other settings, you can optionally hide this level from checkout and disable registration. Most of the time this isn't used, but it would be if you had a membership that you only wanted to set up manually as the admin of the site, or if you wanted a hidden level that you yourself as admin held that was an all access tier that had all membership access available to it. Some people also use this to retire a membership plan that they don't offer anymore. So if you've been in business for 5 years and then you decide that you don't want to offer your premium tier anymore, you want to create a new level and have all of your members migrate to that one, you could hide that level from registration and from checkout. It wouldn't affect anyone that already has that membership level. It would just prevent new people from signing up. So I'm not going to set that here. If I click save level, you'll see that now this has become part of my main group. I can click through to edit it. I can duplicate it, or I can delete it, which maybe we don't want to do. We're just setting up. It recaps what the cost is, and this allow signups is a direct link to the checkout page for that tier. You'll see this notice we haven't set up a payment gateway yet, so this actually wouldn't charge anyone. But you can see here, I already have basic. Purchasing premium will remove our basic membership. This is that level description we added, a recap of the pricing, and then I'm already logged in. I have the current gateway set to just our testing gateway, so you'll see that's asking for billing address, which is not a required section to complete, and the payment information here. So that's just setting up a membership level. We've gotten to this point where now we have a free and a paid tier. I show you our membership levels page so you can see how we have these two options. Me, as the admin, I already signed up for basic, and I also have the new premium tier I can select here. That's initial setup and setting up your membership levels in paid memberships.